I'm honored to see today near Herman Zapp, a man that is traveling around the world with his family in this 1928 Graham-Paige.
Many cars, like Porsche, already in the 40s or even the 50s, they didn't have them in the road. Has aluminium piston, and that time was something like
aluminium piston.
Yeah,
yeah.
That time was something like what?
But the engine was rebuilt or is original?
No, no. We put new pistons and rings in New York.
Okay.
When we were in Wawich, Alaska, and then in Bulawayo, a little town in Zimbabwe, the engine block got a crack, so we rebuilt it. We put new valves, new sleeves, timing chain, new rings, but we kept the pistons.
Yeah, but you changed the pistons earlier, so
now yes, the same piston we kept. Yes, but the piston we put them before was in 2002, and the engine broke in 2014. So they were 12 years old pistons that we were using every day. But they look so beautiful.
Not even the rings on the pistons?
We did change.
Ah, the rings, yeah.
We did change because we had to put sleeves, and we have a crack, we had to put a sleeve. So when we put a sleeve, we had to change the rings.
That's an engine rebuild, actually.
It's engine. Complete.
But the rest of the car, it's from 1928.
Yeah, but the engine before I bought it was rebuilt at least 3 times, eh? Because it was in use a lot, this car. It was not like in the 20s it was used and then they put it in a storage. No.
So it may have more than 1 million kilometers, for sure.
Maybe, right? Maybe.
For sure.
Maybe.
And
maybe. It's used to drive, it is used to go. It doesn't stop. And if you hear the engine start so easy. And
the gearbox has 3 gears?
Yeah. And you should see the gearbox something like this on there. Can put it up with one hand, it's so...
The gears are not synchronized, right?
No, no, you have to double clutch.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. Or wait, you know? You have to wait with your hand till you feel it and then you push it.
But you drive slow, so you have a slow
I'm not in a rush. I only have one life, so I want to take it completely.
And the rest of the cars, I mean, the tires... How? Where do you find tires like this?
Well, now? Look at this one. With this one, they were rebuilt. You see?
Oh, yeah.
This one was in Ethiopia. Because in Ethiopia, they don't let you import tires.
Okay.
So we had to rethread them. Then in many countries, you will see videos that we have the car on tractor tires.
Okay.
There's those one with the 3 lines.
Mm-hmm.
Very good for the sand. Very, very good. So those sandy countries like Namibia, Botswana, Zambia was so much sand, we were driving off roads many times, it was perfect, you don't get stuck. And these are the more proper ones, because here we have so many much more regulations, right? So we had to be under control. But in India we were using ADV tires, they are animal driving vehicles.
Oh, for carriages.
Yes. Really bad quality, really bad, but so cheap, so you can buy another set.
But they weren't even round, right? You feel the bumps in the tire while driving. Yeah, and during bad weather, do you have windscreen wiper? Only one.
Yes.
But usually you don't drive on bad weather, or if it catches you?
Yeah, of course, if it catches me, it continues, but if you get very bad, we should stop, right? But this is, it never stops.
It's manual, working. Yeah.
He never break. He never ever, since I started, I never had to fix it.
And this is the air conditioning, right?
We have air conditioning, and also we have wind conditioning.
Oh!
Right? This is for the feet, right? For the feet, go straight to your feet.
Okay. And when it's warm and nice outside, you drive slow and open the whole windshield.
That's right, that's so right. Also, we have a pop-up tent.
Yeah.
And it go up and then to the sides, so the whole kid can sleep up there.
And you sleep
and
in
mommy
the car?
Mommy and daddy go here because all the seats go down.
Yeah, and you make a huge bed.
And you can see we have a Velcro for the mosquito nets.
Oh!
So we have mosquito nets in each window. We have also, you see these hooks for the curtain, to go curtains all around. And we have the tent to cover the whole car.
And how often do you sleep in the car? So, or did you sleep in the car?
I sleep in the car mostly I have to look to sleep in the car, because we have mostly so many beautiful invitations from people homes, and we look sometimes to have our own time, and we do camping.
Okay.
But also it's a good chance that you'll be able to do camping anytime, just in case that you cannot make it somewhere or anything. But in so many places we were in front of the ocean and with the best $3 million view, sleeping in the car. We were also in, you know, in national parks in Africa with so many animals around.
I saw some pictures with elephants. Yeah.
You know, we have a small home, but we have a big backyard, and we want to see it all.
And I have to ask you this: what was your favorite place?
If New I Zealand? Close my eyes to remember, I see people faces.
Yeah, but the surroundings.
Yes, yes. I don't know, because the Atacama Desert in Chile, but the Amazon in Brazil, but you know, the Bodhi Desert in China, and the Himalayas in Tibet, and
you went
the islands in Philippines. And how can you choose? It's so hard.
You drove in Tibet with this car on the mountain.
Yeah, 5,300 meters.
5,000.
And we got a blizzard, a very bad blizzard with so much wind and snow, right? And we couldn't see nothing, and thank God Tibetan people make a sign to go to their home. We got in, and next day there were so many accidents on the from the last day. And
the car didn't broke there.
No, thank God.
It only breaks where you can repair it.
It's amazing. So far, touch wood, we always find the right people in the right place, right? We don't break in the middle of nowhere.
Okay. The priority is to fix the car and get moving.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Whoa, pretty tight in here.
Thank you so much.
So no seat belts?
We didn't put anything in the original.
So you didn't modify it at all, the mechanics?
No.
The same, like
the only thing I did change was I put alternator.
Okay.
Because you know the old system is for 6 volts.
Yeah.
Very hard to charge battery, right?
Okay.
But with this alternator changed very good and 12 volts. So then when I go home I can put 6 volts again, but for the journey better 12 volts.
So you have to change a lot of things. All the lights now are on 12 volts,
mm-hmm.
And the dash is those indicators are working on 12 volts now.
Yeah, they are all mechanical, only.
Ah, okay. I see.
The oil pressure is not electric. The battery charger is the only one that can work with electricity. But then the speedometer is mechanical. The oil works with the pressure of the oil.
Did you ever thought to change your car?
No, now that I know it, no way, man. Now what? That I know it. And it's also perfect for the journey, because you go in a city and it looks perfect in the city, right?
Yeah.
You go to the national park, it looks perfect in the national park.
Yeah, but it would be easier to drive in a motorhome.
Yes, in a national park, in a city. Can you drive a motorhome in a city?
Okay.
Imagine, it's not allowed. Yesterday I was in Bucharest, in the downtown, and it's very...
Narrow streets, yeah.
Narrow streets. How would you drive a motorhome there? And try to drive a motorhome in the sand in Namibia National Park. Try.
Okay, a big SUV then. Would be better?
Yeah, but it won't look nice in a city. We look like out of the... No, it has to do with style.
Yeah.
Style.
You're traveling
plus,
in style.
How much is the SUV?
How much does it cost?
Yeah,
how much? Maybe 30-40,000 euros.
Well, this one is $4,000. So why will I like, spend 10 times more in something that is only fit out there, but not in the city?
And this is exotic. Completely exotic.
No, this is totally, completely style.
Yeah, it's stylish because those plastic cars, they have this stylish design that will never be replicated again because of the legislation. Now the cars have to be safe and there's no... It's not possible to design a car like this today.
It's not safe. This car is not safe.
I mean for the pedestrian. If you hit a pedestrian with this design, it's dangerous for him. So, no way you're not selling it, you want to drive this car on the way home. I'm sure you have great memories and great experience during this trip. But do you, can you name the best of them?
The best experience, I don't know, the people, right? The people is the best experience because you can see beautiful places, beautiful beaches, mountains, but after a thousand mountains, it's just another mountain, right? But people, wow, man, people are the best part of the trip.
How do you count the number of people you meet?
No, but there are many, eh? I know, but there are many. We were more than, I don't know, 1,300 homes.
1,300 homes?
Yeah, that we were staying. And when we left, people told us, be careful with people out there, they're gonna kill you. But no one told me, go, people will help you.
But I read that somebody once tried to rob you, only once.
Yeah, but count with, compare with all the other numbers. So you, would you let that person eclipse all the hundreds of thousands of people who were helping me? If you only focus on the bad thing, you're not gonna enjoy much life. I'm enjoying the beautiful thing. Austria.
So now you're going towards Hungary and then Austria, Germany?
Yeah, that would be lovely, eh?
Oh man.
And so you wanna much to enjoy.
Go towards Norway till the end of the year?
Yes! Can you imagine?
And do you intend to go back home?
I am a home.
Yeah. Yes, but you're in the country you've been born in.
I was born in USA, I was born in Argentina. And my father was born in Germany, and my grandma in Estonia, my grandma in Lithuania.
Oh, so that's why you want to travel, actually.
My mom from Algeria, maybe I am a gypsy.
No, but you have so many origins, so that's why you want to travel.
Because I grew up like an eagle, not like a tree. Right? I don't want to be stuck in one spot, eat the same food, the same day after day. Same view. I want to see it all.
And you tried all the local food.
Oh yes, Mamma Liga. I had to try, right? Let's go to eat Mamma Liga. It's not Italian, Mamma Liga.
No, it's Mamma Liga.
Mamma Liga.
Yeah, we have the. And do you try also local wines or beverages?
I'm not so much into alcohol, right?
No,
I'm not.
Because you drive so much. And you should try wine in Romania.
I should, eh?
During your journey, you had some breaks. I mean, when you had the kids, you stayed for a longer time.
Well, when Wallaby was born, we stopped in Sydney. 20 days before and 7 days after he was born, we left, right?
It was 7 days old and you left.
Yes, why? Is something wrong? What could be happening?
Do you know what?
He drinks mommy's milk, right?
Yep.
That's the only food, right? He changed nappy and sleep nap. What would be the difference to be? We are still at home, right?
Yeah, because this is home.
Yeah, the whole world is our home. When my daughter was born, she was born with a midwife, right? Also. And she was born and 2 hours later we were in a coffee shop with the baby.
Did any one of you ever got sick during...
I did get malaria.
Oh!
Not that bad, eh? They make big thing, but it's not that bad. It's bad in little kids because they can die.
Okay.
But I did babies, right? 1 to 3 years old. But I didn't have babies with me in Africa, right? And they were bigger. But I was the only one who was not taking the pills for malaria.
Ah, for malaria.
All my other rest of the family were taking.
The first gear is down, and then you go on second and third.
You're right.
And this is the whole gearbox. You finished.
Yeah, and it's such a small gearbox. You should see it.
Do you regret anything?
Have you about it? Regret?
Yeah. Do you have regret?
Yes, of course. Why I didn't start before? Why it took you so long to start, man? Such a beautiful world, so much to see, such a short life, and I tell you, when I was 31, why I didn't start when I was 20?
But the first plan was to go from Argentina to Antarctica.
Alaska.
Alaska, yeah, Alaska and back.
Yep.
And fine. That was it.
Yep.
And you changed your mind.
Well, when you realize how wonderful life can be, how beautiful world we live. Come on, man, let's keep going. It's only one chance. So don't miss the chance. Don't miss. They will call you crazy. They will ask you, what are you doing? They will ask, but be yourself. You don't have to explain why you're doing this. If you feel it, do it.
You have to listen to your inner voice, right? You don't have to listen what others tell you to do. Yeah.
Yeah, be yourself. Dare to be yourself. Dare. How many times you have a chance to be yourself? Only one life. You ask me how long I work with the key, how long, much money, what about breakdown? Everything, those things, always they will work out. Always will work out, but focus in life.
And that was supposed to be the horn out there?
Yeah. Yeah, this one it broke in Africa. All the kids in Africa were hang, hang, hang. So it left forever. Is it green or not?
No.
I'm so sorry, my Romanian is so bad. It's a Graham-Paige, 1928. Thank you, I'm glad you like it.
You've learned during this journey to fix your car by yourself. If you have the tooling, you can do it by yourself.
But not much, not everything, eh?
Yeah, the maintenance.
I was trying to adjust the garage and I did it worse. If I wouldn't know, I would do better, but I feel the clutch worse than before.
As Alex said earlier, you are dangerous because you make people change their lives after they're speaking with you and seeing your story.
But I don't want to change them. I want them to be themselves, to be back to whom they are.
Yeah, to wake up.
If I ask you who you are, what will you answer? Your name? No, you know your name. Your work? No, you know your work. What are you?
My passion?
Yeah, your dream, you're right, your passion, your dream. And how many people are their dream? How many people are their passion?
But you said you had your own business, right?
Yeah, I lost so much time. I made money only. You know how many, so many poor people live in this world that they only have money?
Yeah.
But in this society, we make them the world successful people. We think that they are happy people, that they're so poor if they only have money. You say that you will make stories with the videos about their car and the story of the car with the people. Well, many rich people have hundreds of cars without no story.
Yep.
Maybe one guy has a Fiat 500 from the 70s, he's still building up for 10 years. He has more stories than someone who has 10 Bentleys.
Yeah, unfortunately, because I ask people when did you buy the car, and they tell me 5 years ago. And before that, do you know who owned it? No. Yeah. After you arrived back in Argentina from Alaska, stayed for a while in Argentina, or you
left? We were 2 years traveling from bottom Argentina to bottom top.
Okay.
Also going back and forward with Chile.
Okay.
And also we brought our book.
And those are the best stories when you improvise.
Yeah.
You have no plan at all.
Yes, yes.
You
yes.
just
do it.
Because
that's
you,
so right. Just do it. Jump in and do
you,
it.
You didn't have this plan in mind when you left from Argentina. You didn't know which.
Yes.
You didn't know.
I was gonna have 14. I was gonna run out of money. I was gonna be so many family homes. I wanna be in Romania.
You don't know what's next after Norway. You said you're going to Norway, and you don't know that. You'll see next year, right?
Yes, you're right. You are so right. We will try to park it here in the theater again.
Yeah,
we will try.
Here, but
maybe he's the son of the king of Spain. So. Ooh, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa. Mm-hmm. Yeah, maledita. Your friend gave you some coins. Yeah.
So, you're gonna stop it here?
Yes.
Yeah.
So, he's double check.
Thank you so much.
To you, my friend. To you.
No, no. For letting us share.
We thank you.